Hi and welcome to another video. In this video I'm going to be talking about Laravel validation rules. So in Laravel you can create custom rules. So in this example we're going to limit the type of emails that you can use when signing up and registering. So the first thing that I'm going to do is just quickly set up the default Laravel authentication scaffolding. I've covered this in other videos, but I just thought I'd leave this in there so that you can see how it's done. So I'm just importing the Laravel UI composer package firstly. Okay, so that's done. And now we have to just run this command which generates a scaffolding. So instead of using Vue, I'm going to just use Bootstrap because we're not using Vue in this example. So now it's telling us to run npm install and npm run dev. So the first one I'll run is npm install. Okay, so that's finished now. The next command that I'm going to run is npm run dev, which will actually just compile all the style sheets in JavaScript. Okay, that's finished. Let's just see if that's working. So I'm just running this locally with the PHP artisan serve. Right, so we've got our login buttons at the top and register. So right, so now we're going to add our custom validation rule. So this is the command that you see at the top there. So it's PHP artisan make rule, and then the name of your rule. So we'll just call it email rule. And then you can find it in the app/rules folder that it's created on the left hand side. And then basically you get these two methods called passes and message. So in this passes method you return true or false whether it has passed or not, and the attribute and value are what your form is going to send to it. So the value here would be the email address that we're getting sent. So let's just add our rule into the form on the auth controller. So this is the register controller, and these are the standard validation rules that you get. I'm just making them a bit neater so you can see what's there. So this is what comes with it, and then we're going to add our rule in as an extra check. So just new email rule, and then we just need to add it to the use at the top as well. Okay, so that's added. And then just as a test, I'm going to leave this as true, and it should pass. So let's just try and make sure it all works still, because it's returning true. It should just pass as accepting that that validation rule passes. So yeah, that works. So let's go back and change it to false, and then we should see that the validation fails, just to show what's happening. So as long as it's a valid email here, it should get to our rule. So the validation error message, because we've not set that yet, that's what you see in the message method there. So what we want to do is use these Laravel helpers, which you can find in the Digging Deeper section, and use the string helper, which is ends with, so we can detect what the email ends with. In this first example, we're going to check that the email ends in .ac.uk, which is an like education email in the UK, so a lot of companies want to sign up only people with that address. So let's do that as an example. So I've just copied the example from the documentation and the use statement at the top. So the first part is the string that you want to check against. Or some people say the haystack. And then the second part is a needle. So we're passing in the value, which is going to be the email address, and we're checking that it ends in .ac.uk, and then we're returning the statement. So if it does end in .ac.uk, it will return true, and if it doesn't, it will return false. And then we're just setting the message, so the validation message that we'll get back if it fails. So let's give it a test. So this should fail because we're just putting blah.com, not .ac.uk. So there, the email does not end in .ac.uk, so that's worked. So let's try it with .ac.uk and see if that's any better. Yeah, so that's worked. So that's the first thing that you can use that for. And then another reason to use this is there's a lot of temporary email address websites where you can create a temporary email address, which is not any use to you as a software developer. Like, you don't want people to really sign up with these. So as you can see here, there's like sharklasers.com, which is a common one. So what we're going to do next is write a rule to disallow any temporary, sharklasers.com will disallow that just as one. Obviously, you could add like an array with loads of these email addresses if you wanted. So I've put an exclamation mark in front of this so that it gives the negative of it. So if it does end in that, it will return false, which is what we need. And then I'm just going to change the message so that it says a temporary email address cannot be used. So now if we sign up with an email that ends in shark@sharklasers.com, which we know is a temporary email address, it should give us that that validation message and not allow the user to sign up. Yeah, so we get our message and it's not allowed them to sign up. So if we just put a random email address in, it does let us sign up, so that's worked as well. So that's two ways there to add some nice email validation to your register form, which I feel like there should be some standard way of doing it in Laravel, but there isn't. So it's not too hard there, as you can see. If you get any questions on doing this or you get stuck, then just let me know.